Hi, I'm Mickey with Forevermore Computer Training. In this video, I will show you how to create a drop-down list in Microsoft Excel. I will be demonstrating in Excel 2016, but what you learn in this video will apply to versions 2007 through 2016. To make data entry easier, or to limit entries to certain items that you define, you can create a drop-down list of valid entries that is compiled from cells elsewhere in your workbook. When you create a drop-down list for a cell, it displays an arrow in that cell. To enter information in that cell, click the arrow and then click the entry that you want. Okay, let's create a drop-down list. First, you will need to create a list of valid entries for the drop-down list. Type the entries in a single column or row without blank cells. This list can be in the same worksheet or another worksheet. I like to keep my list in a separate worksheet, which I usually name Data. I like to keep several sets of lists in this worksheet. Sometimes I hide this worksheet to give my tabs a cleaner look, but this is personal preference. Now I am going to do a few extra steps. Convert the list to a table and name the range. First, I will format my list as a table. I will select the range that has my list, then on the Home tab, Format as Table, select a table format style that I like. I do not have a header for my list, but if I did, I would check the My Table Has Headers box. Because I did not have a header, I now have a column 1 as a heading. It is not necessary that you rename this, but I like the look better, so I will rename the heading to City. I also want to rename the table. Select any row on the table and navigate to Table Tools, Design, Table Name, and rename the table to something that makes sense to you. I will name this table City. Now, select all records on the table, excluding the header. Then navigate to Formulas, Define Name, and give the selected range a name. Since I named the table City, I cannot name the range City. If I try to define the range name the same as the table name, I get an error. So I will name this range City Data. Okay, so why so many steps? By defining our data range as a table, we never need to adjust the data validation range if we want to add more values to this list. Excel will handle it all. I will demonstrate once we get to that point. Here is a useful hint. You may want to sort the data in the order that you want it to appear in the drop-down list. Once you have your list typed out, named, and defined, go to the cell where you want the drop-down list. In my example, I have a column heading of City in the Customer's worksheet. I will click on cell D2. On the Data tab, in the Data Tools group, click Data Validation. You should automatically be in the Settings tab. In the Allow box, click the drop-down arrow and select List. Click in the Source box. I define the name of the range as City Data. I will type in equal City Data, no spaces. Make sure that the In Cell drop-down checkbox is selected. To specify whether the cell can be left blank, select or clear the Ignore Blank checkbox. There are two more tabs, the Input Message and Error Alert tabs. In the Input Message tab, you can have a message display when the cell is selected. Under the Error Alert tab, you can have an alert display if invalid data is entered. I will leave both of these alone for this demonstration. Once you are done, click OK. Notice that there is a drop-down arrow on the right of the cell now. When I click on that, I see my list of cities. To copy the drop-down list to the other cells in the column, I am going to use the autofill feature. I will place the mouse pointer in the lower right corner of the cell. When the pointer changes from a fat plus sign to a small plus sign, click hold and drag down. You could also copy and paste. Now I will show you why we created a table from our list. Let's say I need to add a couple of more cities. Back in my list, I am going to add Golden and Aurora. Then go back to the Customers worksheet and click the drop-down arrow. My update is already there. We can easily add values to the list by simply adding new values to the source table. And that is how to add a drop-down list in Excel. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. If you have any comments or suggestions on future tutorials, please leave them in the comments below. Until next time.